हेलो
हाय चेतन, गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग संदीप। विल चेक द स्क्रीन नाउ।
या श्योर।
Is it visible?
Yes, screen is visible. Yeah, perfect.
So we'll start in 5 minutes.
All right.
Me collect some files.
Okay.
Good evening, guys. I hope the screen is visible to all of you.
Yes, it is visible. Chetan, you can go ahead.
Yeah, we'll start. Okay, so good evening. We will start today's agenda. Before begin with today's agenda that related to tracking, still other participants are joining. We will start the balance concept, which we have not covered yesterday. I think we have not covered resource sheet. Resource usage sheet yesterday. Okay, so we'll begin with that. Today, I'll just brief you about today's agenda. We'll try to cover all these concepts of procurement schedule, then resource usage. What is meant by resource usage? These two concepts we have not discussed in last sessions. Then we will begin with tracking. Okay, tracking. Lot of participants have asked that I have not assigned any resource or any cost to my schedule. Then, still I am tracking my schedule. Okay, so it means you are nothing but tracking your schedule for the sake of finish variance or your slippages of different activities, which results into delay. Okay, so you can call it as a bar chart tracking or schedule tracking for the delay analysis. Next, we will also see the tracking of resource and cost also, because now we all are aware about the assignment of resources and respective cost. Okay, and also I'll try to cover the EVM today itself. Okay, so we'll start with the procurement schedule. Yesterday I have discussed one concept of procurement. Okay, block work
we have taken two example. One is related to material and one is related to contractor, okay, or one is related to procurement of contractor. So generally we heard several terminologies like mobilization, then arrangement of all site material and site other you can say safety and other required things on site. So these are subsidiary activities without which you can't physically start the work at site. Okay, so in such cases, if you remember, whatever we have started our case study right from day one, we have planned our execution activities. Okay, please let me remind you, we have started, we are into pre-construction phase in which we are actually scheduling or actually planning our construction activities. For that point, what is important for us is to execute the execution activity, because if you check the graph of planning, execution and handover, the maximum time incurred in your entire project is execution. So we are more interested to perform the execution activities. Okay, that's why we plan the execution activity first and then we plan the subsidiary activity later, though it comes before the execution, well before the execution. Okay, like in this table you will see GFC drawings. Okay, so until and unless you got the GFC drawings, now this is again the common sense point, until and unless I got the final drawing, okay, it's not possible to execute all the required or all the packages, which we do the work on the basis of advance copies on all, which should be avoidable. So what I need in terms of design and drawing, I need drawings. Okay, then if you department wise we'll discuss procurement. Okay, once you receive the drawing, what you require regarding, if I discuss you regarding the quality and quantity. Okay, these two parameters, if you define the quality, then you'll need the SOP or you'll need the specification and all. If you discuss about the quantities, you'll need the entire BOQ. You should understand the quantity of the work also, because you have to discuss with your contractor. Whenever you discuss work with your appointed contractor, always you should carry your entire quantity with you. Okay, so here you will see I highlighted work start in yellow color. What does it mean? I have planned this entire work. You can consider the start date of the work is already planned, where it is planned in MSP. So can I do the backward planning? Can I go and do the backward planning over here? Can I apply that concept over here? Yes, we can. So how to do that? Okay, so we'll just check one example over here and we will go for concept. I'll just open that sheet. I'll also explain you what precaution we should take whenever you create your procurement schedule, because please understand, there might be a question in our mind that procurement schedule, is it a part of construction or is it a part of execution? Okay, in my opinion, you should not create a WBS which you can show in your construction schedule. Okay, if you check here, I have opened one MSP file over here. If you check, it's a around 15 floor building over here, and I have opened one entire file right from site setup to handover works. Okay, if you check the WBS or task ID number over here, it is around 500 activity schedule. Okay, but if I open procurement schedule, if I close this entire construction schedule, please try to understand, this procurement schedule is not part of this construction schedule. Okay, but you can, as a software or as a predecessor point of view, I can relate all these activities. Okay, which activities? For example, if I take the example of this RCC superstructure work, if I open this, if you can check appointment of RCC contractor, machinery, requisition of indents. If you are aware about the indents, requisition, it's a part of requisition. Okay, you should generate, if you are working at site and if you require some material or some contractor or labor, you should raise the indents to your HO or your procurement department. Okay, then work order finalization, then drawings, then consultant drawings, then architectural, sorry, MEP consultant drawing, structural consultant drawing, architectural drawing, your floor plan and all these are related to each other. And in this way, you can attach or you can link these WBS with your execution. Okay. So when should it happen? Of course, we have discussed yesterday one example. I have created a WBS in such a way, if I change my, let me open that. Okay, because this is too much of descriptive file. I'll just open the file which we have discussed yesterday. Is it visible to all of you? Okay, if you check here, now I have given work start over here. Now please concentrate on all these days over here. Okay, you can understand the backward planning that I have mentioned over here. Work start, it is start on 29th of August. Now what does it mean? I have linked my first activity, okay, the procurement of blocks. Okay, the procurement of blocks is related to block work. Okay, so block work, start of the block work, that is first floor of the block work, ID is 148. Okay, so if you check here, I have mentioned 148 SS over here. Okay, so in procurement of the blocks, I have to mention when I'm going to start my work. Okay, so already I have mentioned over here. And now please try to concentrate in this schedule or in this bar chart area. If you check, I have mentioned several milestones over here, because since I'm working in working at sites now, first assumption what I'm going to explain over is my role is based on site. Okay, I'm a coordinator. I'm coordinator and operating all these planning stuffs based from site, based on site. Okay, so here I want to assign the deliverables to respective department which are working from the HO or working from your regional office or site office and all. So for that matter, what I have done, if you check 148 SS, now work start of this block work is having 237 ID over here. Okay, so when should I receive the material at site? 7 days before. Okay, so I have mentioned 237 SF minus seven days. Now what does it mean? Minus seven is buffer time. You should always keep some duration in your hand that you should receive the material, you stack the material, and then you will transport the material. So for that matter, I have created this minus seven lag over there. Next, if I want the material, now please try to understand, as a site engineer or as a project manager, I am saying that I need this material to be delivered on 22nd of August. Okay, so before that, also, it's my job to remind my purchase department, then you should sign your purchase order on 14th of August. Okay, so before delivery of the material, 7 days. Now, purchase manager may say, you don't worry about that. You just tell me when you need the material. Let rest part I will cover. Or rest part is my job. I'll do that. Okay, no matter. But it's a job of one time. Now, please understand this. I'll just change some manual input over here. I'll change some dates in the start column. Now let's see what happened. If you check, instead of 29th of August, if I click on 1st September, you will find accordingly all the dates have been changed. So I have created this entire procurement schedule by using which link? SF, that is start to finish. Okay, so the use of this, where do I use this? This application we will study in tracking. Since you have, I have already mentioned that this work start is related to your execution. Already we have given the relation in execution. What does it mean? Whenever you prepone or postpone your activity, or we can call it as a delay, if we introduce the delay or we consume some more time, then of course your schedule is going to affect in delay. Okay, so with the effect of that, this procurement schedule will also get changed. But what I'm trying to say over here, if you do like this, just I'll show you. If you check, if you include this procurement schedule, if you select and include this procurement schedule under this, then what will happen? Unnecessary, if you are doing that extraordinary delay in your procurement, it will reflect you on your execution period, though it is not directly related to your execution, because procurement schedule, you are not going to execute anything in procurement. Please try to understand. Okay, for example, I have created the procurement schedule for A building. Okay, and you are having a number of buildings in your first phase or second phase, and you have received the material for B or C building, and then you have consumed some material to A building. You are taking care of your own building, that I'm not going to carry out any delay in my respected building, because I'm just discussing one assumption with you. That's why what I'm trying to say, do not make this procurement short schedule part for under this execution part. Okay, otherwise the delay and then percentage completion, the actual percentage progress and all will be deferred, or it will show different values over there. Okay, so keep it outside like this, so it will not get affected. But this will give you the reference when we can actually check out the deliverables of purchase or contracts department. Okay, now we were at this point. Now approval from management, purchase order, already we have mentioned. We can use the MSP sheet and we can give the reminders, or we can send it the mails to our purchase department that my third slab is going to complete. Now please try to understand what I'm saying. My third slab is going to complete on so and so date. So the appointment of block work contractor, or the appointment of the block work cluster contractor, should be done on so and so date, so that he will mobilize and then we can start the work and schedule date of time. Okay, so that's why we have mentioned this procurement schedule. Next, if you check, only purchase order is not a deliverable of purchase department. He has to get the approval from management. Okay, he has to do the offer comparison, he has to take the quotation from suppliers. Okay, now please try to understand, I'm explaining you the backward planning over here. Okay, he has to check the purchase requisition also. Now who generates this? This is the job of site engineer or site manager. Next, if you check, if you are having estimation or budget department with you, they have to define entire budget in ERP first. Okay, first foremost thing in our any planning is design and quantities. Okay, design drawings and quantities. Okay, so if I am having the quantities and the BOQ, then I can smoothly plan my activities for further procurement and all. So I hope you have understand the meaning of procurement schedule, which we can use or we can implement in MSP. A lot of time it is not done, because always we are hurry in preparing schedule of execution, and always we are hurry to track the activities and get the finish warrants. A lot of time we only use MSP for checking the delays. Okay, so today we will see it is not meant for only that, only for that. Okay, so this is about the procurement. Okay, so I'll open the contract also. If you check, same as if you call the order concept in purchase as a purchase order in contract department, what you call that document? Work order or contract? Okay, so here you'll find material delivery, here you'll find mobilization of that contractor. Okay, or mobilization of entire material, labors and all. Okay, now somebody asked yesterday asked that can I put my resources for these activities? Yes, you can do it. You can go ahead and create the resources in the resource sheet and you can post here. Now my suggestion is to do not give the milestones over here, because here my assumption is I am not worried about how many days or how many time, how many days contractor is going to take to mobilize all the material or all the labors over there. Okay, I'll give him one date. Okay, please try to understand my role is from client or consultant. Okay, I'll just give him one date. Okay, indirectly I'm going to study his mobilization period, don't worry. But what I'm trying to give, see here, my work is going to start on 29th of August. And here you'll find I have given minus 10. Now in my study or in my analysis, this minus 10 days or this 10 days is nothing but the mobilization period. So I'm not interested to track his each and every one day of mobilization. Okay, on this day, how many labors have come, how many material have reached from contractor. I'm just checking the date, whether he is working or not. Okay, if I'm interested, then delete this zero, cancel this zero, and just what you can do, just mention the duration over here like this. Okay, but whenever you mention the duration like this, what will happen? You have to cancel this minus 10 duration. Okay, if you check the same values you are receiving. Now in this case you can assign the resources for mobilization activity also. Okay, so in this way you can create or assign the resources for your subsidiary activities. What does it mean? Which are not directly considered as execution activities. Okay. Okay. So we'll open the PPT. Okay. So this is the procurement schedule I have explained. Next, we'll check the concept of resource usage. Yesterday, we have discussed the concept of task usage. What does it mean? Okay, if you remember, task usage is view of what parameters you are receiving from that. At the heading, you will find the name of the task or activity. I'm talking about the task usage. Okay, in task usage, you have found activity as a heading level and followed by resources. And also you will get the cost over there. Okay, but in resource usage, the view is quite different. Okay, though it is giving the same output, but the view is different. If you check here, your resource is at heading level. At the heading, you will find the resources. For example, here you can check it out. Cement is at heading level, and wherever you are using this resource. Okay, now cement is widely used resource at our site. I'm using this resource, or I'm using this cement at footing, for slabs, for block work, for waterproofing. N number of activities are there wherein I consume this resource. Okay, so what MSP will give you? The distribution of the resource over the period of your activity. Okay, the scheduled activity. Okay, so let's check how do I get that view, because we have discussed the task usage. Now we'll discuss the resource usage. Okay, just 1 minute, I'll open this. Okay. check. I'm showing you one new file over here. Okay, here there is a, again I'm explaining you one multi-storied building, wherein I have, if I double click on any slab, just check it out. Here I have mentioned the consumables. Now this is again a CSM. What is CSM? Yesterday I have discussed company supplied materials, because here I have not appointed the contractor based on L plus M, or we can call it as a total package contractor, like RCC with material contractor have been not appointed from my side. I have appointed only centering contractor. Okay, I have given you the consumable from my side. Okay, so in that case, cement, metal, this reinforcement steel, wire, binding wire, and all these I have provided, and I have appointed a contractor based on square feet. If you check here, RCC built up area rate. A rate, it's nothing but a contractor. I have not mentioned the contractor name here. Okay, so in this way I have assigned the resources. Okay, now where do I from where I have assigned these parameters? Okay, from this sheet. Which is this sheet? This is resource sheet. Where it is? View resource sheet, and you will find all the material resources over here. Okay, so we'll check the resource usage view. Where it is? We can go into view view option. In view, you will find resource usage. It is available below that view, and you can find this resource usage by using view bar also. If you check here, you'll find resource usage is there. Okay, so view resource usage. Okay, now what do you receive in resource usage? Okay, now this is again a very good or very important sheet that you can prepare with your project manager or construction manager, and you can discuss this with your procurement department also. Okay, because ultimately, see, BOQ is a quantity required for that material. BOQ is not quantity required for the project, which is distributed over the period of the project. Okay, I have added one more sentence: over the period of the project. In BOQ, you will find only quantities, not its distribution. Okay, so where do I apply, and where from where I can generate that report? You can use MSP for that matter very effectively. Okay, like here I'll open RCC, because RCC, even all activities I have assigned. Here you will find there are several groups have been created. One, first you will find unassigned. It means you can check which all are those activities wherein I have not assigned the resources. Okay, now such resources like line out works, this plot excavation works, these are not the activities wherein I have assigned any material over there. But if you check OBD paint, acrylic paint, this putty and all other aluminium windows and all, these all consume some resources. That's why it has, you can see the quantities over here. Okay, so I'll just check where my RCC activities, sorry, where my resources wherein I have mentioned the RCC activities. Okay, if you check, cement is there. If you open this, cement is applied to all these activities. Now here I have not mentioned any long form over here, so it might get create some confusion. This third slab is nothing but the activity related to my block work. Okay, so what I'll suggest you to, please, whenever you write down your activities in your Gantt chart or in your bar chart, please mention the technical name. Like if I want to mention first floor waterproofing, then write it first floor waterproofing. Do not write the heading, like write the summary task name is waterproofing and under only first floor, second floor, then such kind of error may happen. Okay, so I always tell many of the participants, then always mention your technical name in your bar chart. Okay, so here you will find cement is going, I'm going to use this cement for this all activities RCC. If you check here, you are having total quantity. You can check your BOQ quantity in this work column. Okay, now do not get confused in resource usage with this work column. This work will show you all the resources, okay, all the resources, whether it is material or whether it is work type resource, it will show you all the resources. Now I have received first output, the total quantity of the work, and what about the distribution? You can check the distribution over here. Okay, now here, can I change? Yesterday also I have told you that whenever you submit such kind of procurement schedule, then procurement manager may ask you that in this way I cannot do the procurement. For example, if you check here, in the month of November and December, what you are requesting, I am in the requirement of 1800 cement bag. I'll require 1800 cement bag. So MSP is given me a requirement of MSP has given me the requirement of material distribution as per as prorated part is concerned in our resource sheet. Okay, so here we'll find the distribution. If you don't want to show this distribution, what you can do, just do like this 1835. I have written direct this quantity in November. And do not forget to delete this. You can delete this from here. Okay, so in this way you can create. Now this deletion of resources, material resources, will not hamper your project duration, don't worry. Okay, it will change your assignment dates, okay, but it will not change your project duration over there. Okay, so here you will find 1835. I have mentioned in November. Why? It's a simple common sense that I'll go for monthly, I'll go for bulk purchase, bulk material. So in short, if you check in front of this cement, I'll need 1835 plus 1632, because this 1632 is again related to my fifth floor. So if I check the total of these two, you'll find 3600. Okay, so you have to convey your procurement department that I will require around 3600 cement bags in the month of November. Okay, so this is the view of resource usage. Okay, so if you check, always this open this detail column, because you'll see the units and all. Okay, square feet, cubic meter and all, you'll find over here. Okay, so this is the list of the resources against the total quantity and the distribution for that matter. Okay, so we'll move for next concept. So I have shown you one example over here. Now okay, so what if I want to generate this report in Excel sheet? I do not want to copy all the values from MSP and I do not want to paste in Excel, because it will take so much of time. So how to do that? Okay, I want to see. Many a time it happens your procurement department do not understand MSP or any Prima or such kind of software. So since we are using Microsoft package, so can we take benefit out of it? Yes, we can. How to do that? Here I have mentioned one step. Okay, to get the report in Excel, if you want to check your resource planning, if you want to show the report of resources which you want to allot as per your project duration, which already we have performed by using resource usage, but I want that report not in MSP file, I want that report in Excel file. So how to do that? That we'll check. Now please remember this step: report, visual report, and resource work summary report. Okay, we'll open that. But whenever you open this report, please make sure that you have mentioned all the you have assigned all the resources over there. For example, here if you check the block work, I have assigned all the block work. If I double click here, here you will find 600 by 200 by 100 blocks. I'll require 2.04 cubic meter. Okay, if you want to see, I have purchased, or I have my fashion is to my fashion of purchasing the block work, blocks is in meter cube. Okay, so it doesn't mean that you can't perform the numbers and all, yes, you can do that. You can go ahead and show the quantity in terms of numbers. So I'll require blocks, then fixo block that the adhesive required for that block, cement, crescent and all. Okay, so I have mentioned all that. Already I have mentioned you yesterday that you can copy and paste these resources. Okay, so wherever it is possible, please copy and paste. But if you are not sure that the quantity is different, then please copy and paste, but go ahead and double click on that activity, change the quantities of that respective task. Okay, so in this way I have mentioned the material. Now if you check electrical material, you will not find any material over here. Why? Because I have allotted this work package of electrical with material, that is L plus M basis. Okay, next I'll check what resources are there. If you check, I have mentioned the granite over here for kitchen platform and all. There was a noise disturbance. Yeah, so we have created, we have already discussed resource usage. Now I want to see same concept or same view in my Excel sheet. So how to do that? Go to report. You are having the report. Again, we have created a cash flow report yesterday. In same step, you will find the resource work summary report. You are having the list in all tab. You will find resource work summary report. By default, it will show you in weeks. Okay, now please select the month. If you want to go ahead with week, you can. Okay, but please, yesterday one participant asked, is there any fortnight option there? It is not included in this option. Okay, now if you want to create weekly or monthly basis or quarterly basis resource requirement, you can do that. So I'll select month. Okay, and I'll click on view. Now again we have to wait for some seconds. One new report will generate over here. I'll again show again tell you some precautions here. What we have discussed yesterday in cash flow generation, same precaution we have to take in this sheet also. Just I'll open that. It is open now. Okay, so for first instance you will see this. Is it visible to all of you, the Excel sheet resource work summary report? You will not find anything over here. Okay, because whatever I have discussed with you in last 15 to 20 minutes, that entire MSP is having material kind of material type of resource. If I would have assigned the resource based on cost or based on work that we have already discussed in yesterday's session, that will also reflect over here. Okay, now what I'll do, if you find you have received two files over here, one is chart and second is resource usage. Okay, so I'm going to open this resource usage over here. Okay, click on this resource usage. Okay, you will find one table which right now doesn't have any values. Okay, now for that matter, if you have to use the pivot table field here. Now here what by default tabs are open. Now first tab you will see in under values option you will find actual work. Now I don't want that, just make it off. Go to next, you will find remaining availability, work availability and work. Okay, I do not want this remaining availability, I do not want this work availability, I just want the scheduled work over here. Okay, it will show you in zero because whatever changes that we are going to that we want is till we are not done. Resources, let it be like this only. Monthly calendar is off now, make it on because we want to see the distribution of that resources. Okay, now if you find here, it is very important concept, if you find type over here. Okay, type, right now we are into work field. which is unassigned. Okay. Now what is assigned is material. Okay. So where do I get this? Press that on this filter symbol. You will find this filter symbol over here. Just click on that. You will find work material cost. Now this same methodology you can use with your entire MSP file if you want to use this. Against the assumption that you have mentioned all type of resources in one file. Okay, so then you can make it all this option as okay or on. Okay, so I'll just make it off work. I'll make it on this material. Okay, then just press okay. You'll find the list of material over here. Okay, you'll find the list of material over here. If you check, I'll just highlight one resource. I think cement. Okay, because it is going to consumed in several activities. Okay, you'll find cement 23,658 bags in 2019. Okay, let me repeat. Cement. I'll require cement resource 23,658 bags in 2019. If I open this 2019, you'll find the distribution of that entire resources. Okay, in June month I'll require 3,000 bags. In July month I'll require 5,000 bags and all. Okay, so you'll find the total of that entire resource also. Okay, so guys, please try to understand. This is ready-made reports that you are getting in MS Excel, but this is not that much representable. Okay, if you want to represent it very good manner, you can refer this, you can copy this, but here one limitation comes. If I want to change any manual, for example, I'm trying to change something here, it is not accepting the values, cannot change this part of pivot table report. Okay, so if you want to copy all the values and paste it in another Excel file, you can do that. Okay, by doing that, apply your Excel skill over there and create the report in presentable manner. Okay, so this was regarding the resource use sheet or resource usage concept in MS Excel. Okay, so we'll move for next concept. Here I have shown you one example of resource usage created in MS Excel. Okay, so we'll go for next concept of activity tracking now. Just okay, so we'll start first part of tracking. What does it mean? What do you mean by tracking? Tracking is nothing but the whatever we have planned in our pre-construction phase. Now we are into execution phase. Now whenever we are into execution phase, we need to give the actual inputs to our schedule. Okay, now till date we have assumed or we have calculated, we have estimated, and we have created one schedule. Okay, so that schedule is again if we go back in our first or second session, we have discussed that we have created that project duration or activity duration based on some calculative methods or on our exam experience. Okay, so hereafter we will check how we are going to give the input on the basis of actual progress that we have received from site or that we have observed on site or physically we have calculated from site data. Okay, so for that matter we have to understand the concept of baseline first. What does it mean? What is meant by baseline? In MSP you will find tracking at view also. Then we will understand the status date concept also. Okay, so I'll just open one file. Now you'll find one PDF file over here. Is it visible? Okay, now here you will find I have given you a simple, see a lot, it's again a basic concept of tracking, that lot many time it happens that we fails to get actual data from site. Now why it is happening we'll discuss in 2 to 3 minutes in next slide, but what I have mentioned over here is the step of tracking in MSP. Okay, so I think I have covered this entire tracking process using in 3 to 5 pages over here. I'll request all of you that we will discuss the tracking process, but for your practice please read all the steps which I have mentioned here. Okay, now the baseline, to set the baseline, to clear the baseline, I have mentioned each and every point over here, and I have mentioned one table also. Here you will find the 6-step planning concept. Okay, now by reading this 6-step, it may, in first appearance it will give us a simple methodology, but actually it is having some processes. I already mentioned some tables over here. In actual data input, what should I add or what should I delete from? What should I hide from my MSP file when I actually use the file for tracking purpose? Okay, so one by one we will see. Okay, now my first step is to understand the baseline concept. Okay, what does it mean? Baseline is the value or the condition. Okay, please try to understand. Baseline is the value or the condition. Now, what is the value? What do you mean by value? Baseline value. For a example, if I discuss about the time, then the start date and the finish date and the duration, remaining duration, all these values, if I set the baseline as okay, then these values will get converted into baseline values. Okay, so you can't change that. Okay, conceptually you can't change that. By software you can change that, but it is not logical again. Okay, then what do you mean by resources? For example, if I assigned the resource of cement, or if I assigned the resource of any work type, that is your block work mason or any carpenter or fitter, so should I freeze that value also? You can do that. Can I do that? Yes. What about cost? Should I, can I freeze out my cost? Yes, we can do that. For that purpose also we are using MSP. Okay, so we'll check it, because there is no point to discuss too much of theory over here. So I'll just open MSP now. Okay, just I'll open the correct file. Okay, I'll just show you the folder itself. See, I have prepared one folder here. Let me know it is visible to all of you. I have highlighted a folder over here. You'll see here. This is my schedule tracking folder. This one. Okay, P+7 example 8. This is my folder. Okay. So what steps I'll follow? I'll show you, because see, in limited period of this course, I can explain you what is the simplest or simple way of doing the tracking. Okay, in this way, in this folder you will see I have created one again, a new folder, that is, yeah, this one I have created, or I have pasted, you can say I have created the schedule. Now how to create the schedule, we have already discussed in last 6 session. Okay, now we are done with the schedule. I have pasted my entire schedule in one folder like this. I have given 2 names. I have mentioned short form over there, EXP, that is expected, and ACT, that is actual. Okay, now can I do the operation on single file? Yeah, you can do, but first let me explain you the simple way. Okay, so I'll open this file, the demo case study file, P+7 EXP. Now 15th of July, why this 15th of July? This 15th of July is nothing but my status date. On this date I need the progress of that project. Okay, so I'll open that. It is opening. Let me switch to that file. Multi-file files have been opened, so it is hanging. Okay, is it visible to all of you? Okay, now see here, we are into first part. If you remember, we are doing the tracking that is based on schedule tracking. We are right now checking out. Okay, so what operations we need to do, let us understand first the concept of the baseline. Okay, what does it mean? If I open in view bar, concentrate on this Gantt chart. Okay, if I check this, if I press this drop down arrow, you will find tracking Gantt over here. Okay, so I'll press that. Now what does it mean? If you check, I'll just open one, any you can open any of the WBS, you'll find the pattern of this bar chart is slightly changed. Okay, in Gantt chart it will show like this, okay, like this, but in tracking Gantt you will find like this. Okay, here you will find one some percentage and all. So how to recognize that I have created or I have assigned the baseline or not? Okay, for that purpose we have to understand the baseline concept first. Okay, now what is mean by baseline? See, we were into planning phase. In planning phase I have decided that I am going to start this first lab on 12 July, and this is my planned start date, and I'm going to finish it on 2nd of August. MSP is visible, no? Okay, so this was my planning. Okay, in my planning stage, when I did that, if I check the graph, I have created these values somewhere around at this point. For example, for this instance, I have created this entire schedule 1 month before. Okay, for example, you consider I have created this entire schedule 1 month before. Okay, so here now already we have started our work. We have taking the reports from the site that how much resources have been consumed or how much progress you have achieved at site and all. Okay, so I'll draw one line over here. Sorry, I'll draw one more bar over here. Okay, if I tell you that okay, whatever you have planned is now acceptable, go ahead with this plan. I want this plan to be achieved. Whatever we have created our schedule and whatever changes we have done before the execution, okay, you have created some revisions in the schedule, we have convinced your project manager or convinced your construction management or client that this much of time I'll require and all. Once all this stuff is get cleared, now I'm ready to go ahead with my tracking. Okay, so to track your schedule, now this first bar that you have that you are seeing right it here, the concept of this bar or these values will get changed once you start the tracking operations. Okay, so before going to track, I have to fix these values first. Okay, whenever I apply the baseline, what does it mean? If I say that baseline is applied now, it means it should start now on 12th July and it should end on 2nd of August. If you finish before that, then it's good, you have completed that activity before your target. Okay, if you finish later or if you finish that activity by taking extra duration, it means that you have consumed more time, so it will get affected into delay. Okay, so for that matter, first and foremost thing, very important concept, you have to fix the baseline first. Okay, so how to do that? Okay, so for that matter, go to project, perform this step, project, you will find set baseline. Okay, set baseline, again you will find set baseline option is there, press to that. Here MSP will ask you that what do you want? You want to set this baseline to entire project or selected project? Okay, if you want to, if you are not sure about your planning for finishing activities and you are sure about your planning from site setup to my last RCC activity, then I'll perform that set baseline selected task. Okay, so what will happen, we'll check. I'll just adjust these bars. Okay, see, I have to again select this. First step, I'm explaining you, selected task. Okay, set baseline, selected task. If you press OK, you will find only selected task get baseline is assigned to only selected task here. Okay, if you check the finishing activity, baseline is not assigned over here. But I'll suggest you, since we have made entire schedule in detail manner, so why should I go for selected task? I have created entire project schedule, so I'll go for entire project schedule baseline assignment. Okay, how to do that? Project, set baseline. Now if you check here, MSP will give you the indication in bracket that you have created and saved your baseline lastly on. Now it is showing today's date. If you open this baseline again after some 3 or 4 days, you will see that whatever baseline you have saved on last day, it will show in the bracket. Okay, it will not show you in your baseline one and all. Please try to understand. Baseline 1, 2, 3 is this, it is a different concept. If you want to reassign the baseline or create new baseline, then you can go ahead for baseline one and all. Okay, that will I'll explain you. Okay, so baseline one, I'll just press OK. It will show you one message. Baseline has already used on 22nd of May, that is today. Are you sure want to overwrite? Okay, if I press yes, then it will overwrite the data. Okay. So you'll find now, earlier I have assigned the baseline only for RCC. If you check, the baseline is now assigned to each and every activity. See, you can check out each and every activity. Okay, so in this way I have freezed my baseline. Now I'll add some columns. Now please try to understand. I'll tell you some shortcut over here. If you check the set of these three columns, okay, let me repeat, the set of this column, what does it include? Duration, start, finish. Same in this fashion, what you do, add one more set, that is baseline duration. Check all the values have now have been reflected over here. If you check 5 days, here it is 5 days, 3 days, here it is 3 days. What does it mean? Now MSP will do whatever you have planned till date. It will assume that these all value have been finalized. Then for further tracking purpose, I need the baseline values. So baseline start and baseline finish. Okay, so in this way you have added the column to check whether I have assigned the baseline. Is there anything left over here? No, the entire schedule get converted into baseline schedule now. Okay, just save it. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'll add one column here, that is percentage complete. Now please understand one by one, whatever step I have I'm discussing right now over here is already mentioned in notes also. You can check for your practice. Now percentage column is my, I think, third step, because first step is to assign the baseline to entire schedule. Okay, second step is to add this percentage complete column. Okay, next important step is go in project. Now, okay, now the basic concept I have forgot to explain you. See, if this is my schedule, okay, we are into execution phase now. Okay, now if you remember, we have given our project start date. We have assumed our project start date as 1st of June. Okay, day before yesterday, even yesterday also, we have discussed this date. Project start date is 1st of June. Okay, now for example, I have started my entire project on schedule date. Okay, now we are into 15th of July. Okay, this is my activities. These are my activities. This is 1st June, and suppose today is 15th of July. Okay, so why I'm doing this? and want to show this 15th of July as my status date. What does it mean? What is meant by status date? On status date, I need the expected progress of the work. How much of work in percentage or in your physical quantities, you can say, should I completed? Should have been completed, okay, on particular status date, and what I have actually achieved over there, okay. So I'll do that. How to assign status date? Next step, okay. In project, you will find project information. In project information, you will find status date. Click that. Okay, 15th of July. We have decided 15th of July. Okay, now press OK. Now, if you remember the concept of grid line, okay, I'll just show you. Okay, so here just in 1 minute I'll explain you regarding this time scale. See, in earlier case my time scale is set on the basis of week and day. That's why it is not fitting in my entire user interface in my laptop view or desktop view. So if you want to change this, you can double click here. You can create your values. Like I have created on the top of my scale, I need years, so I have selected years. On the bottom of that, I need months, so I have created months. Okay, so in this way you can adjust your time scale. Now I'll suggest you to do not use this. Here you will find zoom in zoom out option. It will create some confusion later. So you are having the option of time scale adjustment, so go ahead and use the time scale. Now okay, so I have added one column over here, percentage complete. Now I want to see the line of status date. Have I applied and is it visible? So from where I can get that? If you remember, we have assigned project start. Now here you will not find project start date. I have not assigned, so I'll just assign with the blue color. And find status date also is there. Okay, just press OK. So you will find this is your blue line is representing your start date, and this red line is representing your status date. So on this date, now whatever activities you are observing at the left hand of this red line, what does it mean? It means that this should have happened, this should completed before this status date. Okay, so assuming that today is 15th of July, we will check the next operation. Okay, so I'll just open that. Okay, so one by one we'll read it, what we are doing right now. See, first we have set the baseline. Okay, we have performed this step number one, baseline set. Second, status date, assign status date. From where I should assign the status date? Project information. Third, I want to show this status date in my bar chart area. I have already shown. Add the column percentage complete. I have done that, so it means some steps may get sequence may get changed, but you can perform any of these tasks, but you have to perform all these tasks. Okay, so I'll open the MSP now. So I have assigned status date. I have added the column of percentage complete now. Okay, so read this fifth sentence. Change the column name. Is it possible to change the column name? Yes, you can do that. Now if at all you do not perform that, don't worry, nothing will change. But to give the better input to your client or your manager, I have suggested this option, because you can do that. MSP have enabled that option. Now what does it mean? Change the name of the column. Now please understand, we are into expected percentage file now. Okay, so change the name of the column of the percentage complete. Right now it is percentage complete. Okay, now I want to change that name of column from percentage complete to expected percentage complete. Okay, so open that file, right click on that column, go to field settings. You will find the original name appears here in front of field name. I can change the title, expected percentage complete. Okay, just click OK. You will find the expected percentage complete appeared here. Okay. Now next step, just we'll read out last and final step of this second file, project update project, and keep the value 0 to 100. Okay, this will some confusion may happen by choosing this option. Okay, go to project. Here you will find update project. In project you will find update project and check whether you have rightly, here you will find second check that I have rightly assigned my status date or not. Okay, 15th of July we have already decided that 15th of July is my status date. Below that you will find update project, click on that. Here you will find again 15th of July appeared. Here MSP will ask you update work as complete through on which date, status date. Here you will find two options, 0 to 100, 0-100, it means 0 to 100. Okay, all the activities which are expected to complete on status date, okay, whether it is WIP, that is work in progress, or whether it is entirely completed, okay, no matter whether it is 1% or no matter if it is 57 or 99% for that matter. So what I'll do, I'll choose this, I'll get this first option itself, and I'll perform this for entire project, not for selected task, because we have already decided to track entire project, not selected task. Okay, if you choose by mistake, if you choose second option, then what is it explaining or what is it defining? 0 or 100%. So it will show you the activity which is not started or the activities which are entirely completed. So go ahead with first and press OK. Now we'll see the values have been reflected. Now please understand, these are I think we are receiving only 4%. So I'll suggest you to change I'll shift this July to September because it is not covering too much of activities. So please bear with me. I'll just do that. How to do that? How to change my status date? Go to project information. I'll choose 15th of September because I need to cover more activities. See, it is now shifted. Again, perform this update project. If you check, 15th September appeared over here. Press on update project and press OK. Okay, so what does it mean? Is this 8% your actual percentage complete? No. Actual percentage complete, you'll need more efforts because actual data input is itself a job of every planning engineer or project coordinator. Okay, here MSP have given you that these are the activities, for example, first slab, second slab, third slab. Okay, till this third slab, you should have complete all the project, all the tasks till the status date, because we are assuming that today is 15th of September. So all these activities, right from your site setup, excavation, footing, plinth, and all these activities have been completed. Now let us check some finishing activities also. Here you will find first floor block work is 7%. That means you should start the block work also, because the status date defines, or the status date is now telling that these are activities that you should start on site. Okay, now because this entire plan is now completed and freezed, or baseline has been fixed now. Okay, so this is your file that that explains you about the expected percentage complete. Okay, now I'll open my PDF again. Here if you check how to get the actual percentage complete. Now for that matter, for this you should include all these columns in your file. Okay, which file? In your MSP file, but not in your expected file. This is my suggestion, because a lot of time we perform all the input, all the tracking, all the updation in one file, which will create several parameters. Again, guys, please try to understand this. We are using standalone MSP, wherein you are not getting any automatic values. We have to create, or we have to generate the automatic values. If you use online MSP or web-based MSP, you will get the values from that, but since we are using standalone product, we have to create or we have to generate the values which is easily understood by every stakeholders or every your from every your to the every you can say the team of your every member of your team. Okay, so I'll open the third file now. Okay, so I have opened the folder. So I have created two file system here. Okay, so first file is telling me that I should complete entire project like this. 8% should my should be your expected percentage complete. Okay, if I open the folder and if I open the next file, here I have opened the next file. Now please understand, whatever steps we have carried out in expected file, okay, I'll just open that steps so that you will understand. Here you will find whatever steps that we have carried out in previous file from the file that that has been used for actual expected percentage complete output. Here the same operation I'm going to perform, but not last step. Okay, please try to understand. I have mentioned it in red color over here. I'll set the baseline, I'll give the status date, I'll change the color, I'll add the percentage column and percentage complete column and all. I'll do all the things, but I'll not perform only one step, that is update project, because update project is not necessary, not required. But why? Because here here you have to give the actual inputs, give the actual performances that have been received from site. Okay, so where do I get the actual data? Okay, so if you check, I have mentioned how to get the actual data. I'll add one more thing, genuine data. Okay, a lot of time it happens, if I pick my mobile phone and if I call somebody at site and ask, I'm in hurry, just tell me the exact work status, so he'll give you any haphazard data. So the point is, we should, or every stakeholder should rely on that data, because you are project coordinator or planning manager or planning engineer for that time. If you want to give the exact data, you should believe on the data received by you. Otherwise, if you are not comfortable with that data, then you have to fix some periodical visits so that you will receive or you can check the exact performance which is happening at site. Okay, so I'll recommend you the first method, that is actual site visit. Prepare your own Excel sheet or prepare your own we can say percentage weightage sheet that will just go ahead and refer your performance checklist. There is a concept called performance checklist. You can go and take whatever milestones or whatever subtask have been under WIP, that is work in progress, or whatever the activities that are in 100% complete manner. Second, if you are unable to go to the site, then you can demand these reports, that is DPR, daily progress report, monthly progress report and all. If you are working as a contracting firm, then MB records available at site, that is measurement book, daily your supervisor or your junior engineer is giving all such kind of inputs. Okay, lot of sites. Okay, lot of sites having delay log register with them. Okay, now several participant asking about the monsoon force major conditions or such lockdown force major condition. These all are delays that is having a force major implications with it, because we do not have any control on such incidents. Okay, so for that purpose, you should always keep the delay log register with you, because this is the point wherein lot of disputes happen. Okay, due to improper management of such registers or some misinformation or several problems happens at site that due to lack of the data, we are not arriving on exact delay or exact finish variances, even though we are using so many of softwares. But if your actual input data person is giving you the wrong data, or his intention might right, but if he is not maintaining the data on regular basis, so how do you give the data, how do you give the input to your MSP sheet or any other sheet like Primer and all? Okay, for that matter, you should create such kind of situation or environment at site that you get data several or periodical instant. Okay, next you can go ahead with one shortcut method, that is percentage allotment. Okay, now all these concept we are going to study in MSP also. What does it mean, percentage weightage allotment? Let me check, I am having that Excel file with me or not. Is it visible? Is it visible now? Now if you check, I do not want to discuss any actual percentage or actual work progress at site. I have fixed my weekly day. I'll go to site and I'll check each and every floor, and you can consider this as my checklist. Okay, so I'll open one. I'll discuss two activities because we are having limited time. I'll discuss RCC activity. Now, what does it mean if I perform any RCC work, any particular floor's RCC work as 100%? What does it mean? This is nothing but your stages of the work. For example, now these stages, please try to understand, you are dealing with multiple stakeholders, contractor or your site team or your HO, head office or your management, all these are your stakeholders. Okay, so these percentage should be convinced by each and every stakeholder involved in this tracking process. Okay, if I go to the site and I am observed that my for example, I am observing my fourth slab, and my fourth slab is now at the end of reinforcement of that slab. The reinforcement of that slab is completed. If you check, the cumulative value of this is 70%. Okay. Now this 70% is acceptable by each and every stakeholder. Acceptable by you. Acceptable by your contractor and your project manager and all. Okay. So if this is the case, then you can prepare such kind of checklist. You go and check. Now please try to understand, you have to discuss with your quality department, safety department also whenever you are working with the site. Okay, so that is again a big discussion point of chapter. So I'll show you one more Excel sheet, one more example of finishing activity. If you check the gypsum punning work, I have created that. If we perform all the reference marking, bull marking we can say, then I have given 10% over there. Then if we use the adhesive, now adhesive will not take that much of time because it is just application like paint, okay, brush application or roller application. It will take 5% ceiling punning and wall punning. So if I go to the site, for example, he have performed these three activities, so I'll allot him the percentage of 40%. Okay, if I go ahead and check that some wall punning work is also done, then I'll calculate the quantities. For example, my entire floor's quantity is 1000. Okay, so if I performed say around 600 square feet, okay, so what does it mean? You have performed simple 60%. Okay, but if you check overall progress, if I do like this 60% into this, then I have performed 36% out of the 60%. Okay, so these you can call it as a physical percentage complete. Okay, now these percentage you can go ahead and give into actual percentage. I'll write it here. You will find 40% plus this. So 76% I have performed. Okay, I have explained you just an example. Now again, please try to understand, this is shortcut method, because it will not take that much of time once you make a habit of performing such kind of checklist. You will just go to the site and perform. Okay, what this is floor number 8, then floor number 8, just roam around that entire floor number 8 with your project manager or your junior engineer or senior engineer. Get each and every data completed. Now please understand, here we are not working as a MSP operator, we are MSP planner. Okay, we are a planner. For that sake, we have to understand the quantities, we have to understand the progress which is actually happened at site. Okay, so this is the concept of taking the actual data from site engineers or site team. Okay, so I'll just open MSP, sorry, this file. So I mentioned percentage weightage allotment against stage of the progress. Now which are the stages? I have already explained you. We have to, now if you want to create some more stages, you can do that. It's up to you how many stages, but I'll suggest you to go ahead with major stages, not because already you have mentioned entire WBS in your MSP. Okay, this we have explained. Now we have to perform this last step. Okay, last step of actual percentage completion or actual percentage data input. Okay, I'll just open that MSP file now. Okay, so I have opened that folder. So actual file I'll open. Okay, step number one, we perform this step immediately because I have to cover some more concepts today. Okay, so please concentrate which are the columns I am going to add now, because this is related to some comprehensive data input, so that's why you have to create some space over here. Okay, now first step, go ahead and set your baseline. How to do that? Project, set baseline, and just select the set baseline and select it for entire project. Okay, how to check that my baseline is set or not? Now I am not able to observe in this schedule because this is, you are into Gantt chart view now. If you want to check your baseline is set or not, go ahead and choose Gantt chart view over here. We'll check. Yes, baseline is applied, baseline is assigned. Okay, next. If you check our steps, first we have assigned baseline, then I have to assign status date here also. How to assign the status date? Go in project, project information, you will find status date over here. We have decided, I think, 15th September. 15 September, choose that 15 September and click on OK. Immediately perform the grid lines also. Show project start date and show project status date also. I'll just check, is it applied or not? Okay, it is applied. You'll find that this. Now please do not update immediately. Okay, we have done in expected file. Please try to understand. Okay, here you'll find expected. Okay, this work has been done. Okay, your step for expected percentage file is finished. Now we are doing which operation? Actual. Okay, so actual is not please do not make the assumption that I'm going to receive the actual percentage on automatic basis. No, it will not happen. We have to perform several operations over here. Okay. Now I'll add some columns. Now how to add the columns? Okay. I have given you the hint. These three columns, you have to remember these three columns, duration, start, finish. In same format, I'll add baseline duration, baseline start, baseline finish, okay. Now, here after we have to add some more columns because I want to give the actual data now. So actual duration, same fashion you have to choose the column in same manner. Actual duration, actual start, and actual finish. Actual finish. Okay, I'll add one more column. Also required for today's discussion, remaining duration. Okay, I will add one more column here. That is important. Percentage complete. We have forgot to add this percentage complete, and one more column, that is finish variance. What does it mean? Finish variance, nothing but your delay. Okay. For that purpose, we are doing all this. Okay. Okay. Now, by seeing these all values, one may get confused that how many values I'm going to give the input. Okay. Now, please try to understand. Tracking is not the process that should be done on daily basis. Okay. You decide your, because see, I'm not aware what project you are dealing with. If you are dealing the project which is having 6 months of duration, you may require the tracking operation to be done at every week. Okay. If you are doing you are dealing with the project which is having two years of the project duration, then you may require the tracking on fortnight basis, that is after every 15 days. So whatever you are giving the input is the data of previous 15 days, okay, or previous 7 days or previous 1 month, okay. But what I'm suggesting you to, please do not increase your pending work, because lot of time it happens that so many of our planner get the data of last previous 6 months, and they were into a very hurry that I have to put all the values in one day and all. Please do not do that. Whatever progress you are achieving, get the data at that point only and give the input. Okay. Now, one by one, we will perform this tracking operation. Now, baseline is set. I have given all the columns over here. Now, please do not, again, I'll repeatedly remind you that please do not update this project. Okay. If you update this project, what will happen? Okay. You will get the same data or same input. What you have received, same output what you have received in expected file. So, okay. So by referring the list, what I have mentioned to you in slide, that how do I get the actual data? Okay. For example, I have visited the site, and now please understand, I have to check. I'll just highlight here. Okay. Now, see, in front of third slab, you will check finish date of that third slab is 13th of September. Okay. Now that's why when you selected your status date in expected file and you press the update project, what you have received, all activities have been tracked to entire project, and MSP have suggested you that these percentage have been converted into 100%. It means your third slab, up to your third slab, the progress should be 100% up to third slab. Okay, so this was the output in expected file. Now in actual file, I have to perform the input of actual values. So I'll open one by one. Since we are having limited time, I'll just do the shortcut, because do not refer this. I'll just explain you later. Now we'll start the tracking work from plinth. Just one second. Yeah, sorry. So plinth work. Now here we should understand some we should take some precaution over here, how to give the input here. I'll just show you. I'll open. Now, whenever you take the actual inputs from the site, okay, for example, my first assumption or first iteration is the activity is 100% completed. So what does it mean? The activity is 100% completed means it has actual start. Okay, it is common sense that it is having actual start and actual finish, because we only defines the activity is actually completed. Okay, now this is about the activity which is 100% completed. Now what about the activity is work in progress? What does it mean? So it means that the activity has actual start, okay, and it has some percentage. Okay, it might have 58% value. Okay, how to calculate that? Now this is again a part of construction management. If you have to check, I have explained you two method. One, the percentage weightage method, which is acceptable to all of your stakeholder. Otherwise, you have to calculate the quantities of that particular or respective activity. Okay, so this work in progress is nothing but what? The activity is in progress, and then you have to check out the percentage which you have received on the status date. Okay, so these all related to status date itself. Okay, so please try to understand, you should receive this genuine data. Now I am calling it as a genuine data, because until and unless you put this genuine data, you will not receive finished variance and such variance parameters over there. Okay, so I'll request you to get some this kind of data from your site. Okay, so we'll go to MSP now. Okay, so start from clean beam works. Okay, if you check, so here it is balanced. Okay, clean beam work. Now please try to understand, you have to, I'll just some raise the font here so you'll understand, because I have received some question regarding these three columns. So today I'll tell you the concept behind this. Now please understand, whatever we have planned in these three columns. Okay, in these three columns, sorry, duration, start and finish. Once we get approval from your management or your manager, okay, these planned dates are okay with us, we will perform all the activity with these values, then you have converted or you have freezed all these values in this next three column. These are your baseline values. Okay, now I want to give the input on these actual values. Okay, now whenever, now please try to understand my terminologies hereafter. Now whatever you perform the actual data input, this actual will affect on these values now. Okay, please, I'll repeat again. Whatever actual data you are going to perform in this actual duration, actual start, actual finish column, this will affect on this duration, because this duration, these dates, this start date, finish date and all, because you are not now changing the values, and the prediction, further future prediction will be reflected in these three columns. Okay, so this is the concept wherein if somebody asks you, okay, you have done the delay of say around 30 days, now let me know when can we predict then when this project is going to end. Let me know the finish date, expected finish date, then you can refer this date. Okay, you can refer this date, not this date, because this is baseline date. Okay, and this will not arrive until you finish entire project over here. Okay, so at this stage, okay, now just bear with this drawing. At this stage wherein your project is under progress, which is not completed yet, which is going to complete after 1 year, 2 year, we don't know. But at any instant of time, if you want to represent your prediction, this when is this project is going to finish, then you can show this date. Okay, so this is the concept, or this is the this you these three fields you can consider that as a predicted or future prediction dates or future prediction duration over there. Okay, we'll perform the operation so everyone will understand. Okay, now if you check my, now just you concentrate on this baseline and concentrate on this actual. Now I have done the planning that I'm going to start my activity on 3rd of July and it is going to finish on 5th of July. For that matter, I have checked the actual progress, actual situation at site. Then I got to know that this activity has not started on 3rd of July. It is started on 4th of July. Okay. So we have to give the input like this, 4th of July. And now check what happened here. We'll check all this column is converted into light blue color. It means the value is changing. Wherever the value changes, MSB will indicate in light blue color over there. Okay. So it will give you the prediction. Now, here, my start variance is how many days? One day. What is meant by start variance? We always check the finish variance. Finish variance is nothing but the delay. Once the work get completed, then in how many extra days I have performed that activity? It means the delay or finish variance. But if you check here, my baseline start is 3rd of July. Okay, I started it on 4th of July. It means start variance is one day. Okay, now it is supposed to finish on 5th of July. MSP is now telling you it may finish on 6th of July. Now please understand my terminology. Okay, I'll try to explain you in simple manner. Okay, 6th of July. Okay, MSP is now predicting that this clean beam work is going to finish on 6th of July. Okay, so based on your actual values. Okay, now we'll perform since this activity is not completed. Now again I'll check. Again I'll ask to my site engineer or my site data. I'll check, and I got to note that this activity has been actually finished on 8th of July. So just give the input 8th of July. Okay, so you'll find 2.88 days. Now this fraction will come. It means you have delayed this entire activity by how many days? 3 days. Okay, how many days? 3 days. Okay, so in this way, now here you will find, since you have finished this activity on 8th July, okay, your next plinth filling and compaction work baseline finish was 8th July, but MSP will now tell you that it is not possible on 8th of July because you have delayed your previous activity. Now it is going to finish on 9th of July. Okay, now it's your job to input. Please understand, it is physically not finished on 9th of July until unless you give the input, until unless you are sure about this value. Okay, so I will start my next activity, plinth filling and compaction. Now plinth filling and compaction, this started on say around 7th July. So I'll give this input of 7th July and it is finished on 11th July. Now I'm haphazardly, I'm not giving any input. Now please assume or please predict that I'm having one sheet in my hand, which is received from site. Okay, I'm having actual input over here. On the basis of that, I'm giving the input. Okay, so I'll just press 100%. Now this is again a shortcut method, or sorry, this is not a suggested method because we are not having that much of time, that's why I'm performing. Okay, now please understand on this, please concentrate on this first slab. Okay, now we are at, today's date is 15th of November. Okay, we have considered our status date as 15th of November. Okay, but when I went to the site and I checked, I have performed only two slabs. Okay, there is no work happening for the third slab. Okay, so on the note of common sense, I have to give the input only for these two slabs. Why? Because I have performed two slabs. The answer is very simple, because on that day, on 13th or 15th of November, no activity is happening on third slab. Then I have to give the input to these two slab itself. Okay, so I'll just open that and I'll give the input from this. Okay, now here you will find MSP is saying that you are going to you can start your work on 14th of July. This 14th of July has been reflected based on previous actual input data. Okay, but if you want to check the original start date, original baseline start date, you can check in baseline start column 12th of July. Okay, originally it should start on 12th of July. By referring the actual data at site, by whatsoever reason, I have checked that this activity has started on, say, around 20th of July. Okay, several delay happens at site, so I'll choose 20th of July. One by one, if you want to give one by one input, of course you should give one by one because we have created the subtask. Okay, please do not perform the summary activity for that matter. If you want to do that, MSP will not allow you to give actual finish date to summary activity because you have created subtask over here. Okay, so here we have increased our work here. So we don't have any other option because we have created the WBS. So we have to perform the WBS. That's why I'm saying you, first thing first, we have to perform such kind of actual data input on the day, pre-decided day. Okay, so I'll perform this here. I have started this on 20th of July. I'm going to finish on it on, say, around 25th of July. So one by one, I'll start this. This again, beam bottom work have been delayed. So I'll perform like this, 26th of July. And this I have finished on 29th of July. One by one, you have to give the input like this. Okay, 21st, 31st and 3rd of August. I'll just perform for first slab, one slab only, because this slab and beam reinforcement work, again, I have observed the delay over there. It is started on 3rd of August and this completed on 9th of August. Okay, if you check the beam and slab reinforcement work over there, previous was stuttering. Now we have checking the reinforcement. It is started on, say, 10th of August and it is completed on 17th of August. Okay, conduit work, it has started on 14th of August. And it is finished on, say, around 19th of August. Consultant checking, I'll just do it 100%. Casting, we have presumed that casting will be done in one day, but due to some delay in concrete or supply of concrete, I have performed that activity in 2 days. Okay, so it is started on, say, around 20th of August and it is finished on 21st of August. Okay, so in this way I have given the input. Okay, now this is my iteration number one, in which I have assured this activity is completed. Okay, now what about work in progress? Okay, now for that matter, I'll explain you in second slab. In second slab, this column reinforcement, it is 100% completed. Okay, my first assumption is it is 100% completed. So I'll, whenever you explain that your activity is 100% completed, then you should mention genuine actual start and genuine actual finish. Do not make like this. For example, if you check on start date, it is showing you 21st August. Now a lot of planning engineers do like this. They choose 21st of August like this, and they put 100% here. Now, what error we will get? You will not get any exact finish variance over here. Okay, because MSP will assume that you have started on whatever date you have mentioned. It is customized date, of course. But if you press 100%, you will check in actual duration column, it is reflecting 5 days. Now, what is this 5 days? This is same as your baseline duration and same as your planned duration. Okay, so this 5 days will reflect over here. Okay, so this is not correct way of doing tracking. That's why I'm saying, if you are assured that your work activity is 100% completed, then please give the input of actual start and actual finish over there. Okay, so do not mention 100% directly over there. Okay, so I know that 27th of August is my actual finish. 100% will remain there. Okay, but you'll see actual duration is 6 days over here. Okay, and the duration is also 6 days. It is converted into 6 days because next days, if you check, these days are same as your baseline duration. It means that if you have not changed anything here, if you check here, and by taking reference of further duration, it will show you further prediction in next columns in start and finish over here. Okay, now since we are in August, it is again rainy season period. Okay, so we will presume that we have started beam bottom work on say around 28th of August, and on site again, please try to understand, today is 15th of September, and I went to the site and I checked that only column reinforcement, shuttering and casting work has been done, and beam bottom work is completed 50% only. If you check the entire floor plate area, the 50% area is completed on 15th of November. Okay, so I'll just write 50% over here in percentage column. Okay, now you'll say, what about next? Now we can't give any input over here because the work has been not happened. Any work has been not performed over there. Okay, so just this is our input. Okay, now I'll give you the concept of remaining duration now, and then we will go we will check our final comparison. I'll just make this visible that you'll get to understand. Okay, I'll just make it 100% because it is having only 2 days. This also. Now please concentrate on this beam side and slab support. Whatever I had done for this beam bottom, I'll perform to this beam side and slab support, because you'll get the concept here over here. Okay, now please concentrate in this actual start again. Now actually this work has been started on 1st of September, so I'll write 1st September. Okay, now if you check, I have not given any percentage over here. If I give percentage over here, now today is, again I'll remind you, today is 15th of September, and I'm checking this beam side and slab support work, that is shuttering work. Shuttering work has been completed 50%. Okay, now MSP will give you remaining duration of 2.5 days. But when you discuss with your project manager or contractor, and if you ask that you are saying that 50% is your work progress, okay, accepted. Now let me know how many more days you'll take to complete this activity. So by discussing and deciding that I'll require 2 more days, or say around 2.5 more days, then you have to mention 5 days over here. Now already 2.5 days already allowed over here. Okay, cumulatively you have to mention 5 days in your remaining duration. So what will affect here in your entire project lead? Now this is, we are doing analysis. Please try to understand, guys. We are doing the analysis. Okay, if I press 5 over here, then MSP will adjust this percentage column, percentage complete column, like this 33%. So though you have completed 50%, but you have not completed entire project, entire activity of that selected task, entire selected task. So you will mention remaining duration like this. So it will give you further prediction. Okay, now how to get the further prediction? Now I'll press Control Z over here. Earlier it was saying, MSP was saying that you may complete this activity. Now please try to understand, I'm talking about beam and slab side support work, that is 56. You may complete this activity on 5th of September, but since you are not capable, or you are not ready with this 2.5 days remaining duration, you are not accepting this 2.5 duration, that because you all are assured that due to labor problem or due to some environmental problem, I need some more duration. So how many days? 2.5. So these 2.5 plus balanced, remaining 2.5, I'll write 5 days over here. So MSP will now tell you that you are going to finish this activity. You may finish this activity on 8th of September. Now please try to understand, we have not finished yet. Now for this instant, I took this challenge, and if I complete this activity on 7th of September, no matter, you can go ahead and write here 7th of September. One, but provided you have finished that activity, okay, 7th of September. So in this way, you analyze your each and every task, and you finish the entire tracking operation of each and every task over here. I'll just save. Now again, I'll extend my assumption that I have finished the activity till shuttering work of that slab. Hereafter, I have not performed anything. Okay, just save it. Okay, now please understand, I have, we are having two files open, MSP file open now. What I'll do, I'll do one more operation here. Okay, here you'll find in view tab, you will find one tab over here. This is your what? This is your, sorry, one second. I'll just delete this, clear this. This is your arrange all. Okay. If you move the cursor over here, these options enable arrange all option. Okay. Here you will find arrange all. If you press this, what will happen? Okay. Multiple files have been opened. Let me delete. For analysis part, I'm explaining you this. If possible, we will cover some concept tomorrow. I'll just talk with Agni team, because a lot of portion is still balanced. So I'll cover that tomorrow. Let me perform that operation once again. Okay, in view, you will find arrange all. Okay, if I want to analyze step wise, go ahead with this. Okay, now I'm having two files open with me. Okay, I'll give you one more step today. So this is my percentage complete, expected percentage complete, and this file is giving me actual percentage complete. So I'll just go to field setting and change the name. Okay, now we'll open the task one by one. Okay, what should have completed? If I check here, site setup, substructure work, entire substructure work in RCC, first slab, second slab, third slab should have completed. And what I done, I have completed entire site setup work, substructure work, RCC first slab I have completed, second slab I have not completed 65%. Okay, so it means that I have lagging behind in my schedule with how many days? 22 days. My overall delay is 22 days. Okay, and I'm lagging behind in percentage complete with 1%. If you check activity wise, if you can check, 3 of slab should completed, but you have performed only 2 slab. That too, 2 slab is in progress. Okay, if you check the finishing task, block work should have started, but you have not started the block work yet. Okay, if you check in your actual values, you will find 0% in your block work. Okay, if you open this, you can find 0% is reflecting over here. So, okay, so guys, please try to understand, the various tracking methods are available. Like, I'll show you one more tracking method here. If you go to view, not view, if you go to report, we are having compare project option with you. Okay, if I click this, it will show you the file name. Press OK. It will take some time. And if you want to, it will take some time, because, and please try to open two files at same time. we have to assign some time over here. Okay, see here in percentage I have created two file. If you check here, I'll just we have performed more on RCC activity for that matter. I'll just give you see comparison. We can check over here. 100%, 100%. This is my 65%. I have actually achieved at site, but 100% should have been completed. So variance is 35%. So I'm lagging behind over there. If you want to check the finish variance also, you'll check here. Around 22 days. So you can use this compare project option, sorry, task comparison option or compare project option for that matter. And you analyze such parameters based on your tracking. Now I have explained you two methods. There is one another method, but it is around 8:20. So we'll explain in tomorrow session. Sandeep, can we continue for tomorrow session? Hello.
Yeah, we can continue or as we discussed what we can do. We can have maybe they can practice.
Okay.
MSP, and we can have one more session on Sunday morning.
Okay.
Whatever you suggest.
I am okay with tomorrow. I don't have any engagement in this slot tomorrow. But not possible at morning or afternoon. But evening I can conduct this.
Okay, so then we will have to share a fresh link for the registration. They all might have registered only for the 7 days. So we have to share another link for registration. So that we will do it.
Because the important concept of that earn value and some part of reports is still balanced, because it is not possible to cover in 2 to 3 hours. So for that matter, we'll take this session. We'll continue this session for tomorrow. Okay, so is it comfortable?
Yes. Okay, no problem. You can continue tomorrow. So we will share a fresh link for registration tomorrow, or maybe we'll directly share the Zoom link so that they can join using that link, because this link will expire today. Today, as per the schedule, today was the last day. We will make one more link for tomorrow's session.
Okay, thank you. So thank you guys. So this was for today's session, because two to three beats still balance, that is earned value and all. So we'll discuss that part. Or again, one more part is balanced regarding tracking, that is resource and cost tracking. So today we have discussed actual data input regarding to time or schedule. Tomorrow we'll discuss actual data input regarding to your resources, like your material and cost and work type of resources. Okay. So thank you again. Thank you for your patience. So I'll just copy all the questions so that we will take it in our question and answer round tomorrow. Okay. So Sandeep, should we close then? Because again, we have received more than 50.
Yeah, so we separately, maybe Sunday we can plan one more session on question and answers.
Okay. Thank you guys, thank you once again.
Shall I end the meeting? Did you copy all the questions?
Just 1 minute, I'm copying that.
Okay.
Just save it, because yes, Sandeep. Thank you.
Before you end, let me just save that feedback form. I will save that here only, so that tomorrow we can launch
Okay.
Let me just save it before we end. Give me a minute.
Yeah.
Okay, I saved all the questions. Okay. Sorry, I saved that feedback form. We can end now, Chetan.
Okay, thank you.